Hey robot fans, welcome back. This is the second video in my chopper build. When we left off last time, I was spinning the Lazy Susan round and round after a successful mounting test. Since then, I've gotten a lot of work done. I assembled the rest of the frame. I didn't want to make a whole video about the frame assembly since it's pretty straightforward. All these parts are printed to fit together, and then once they're fitted together, they're just solvent welded in place using some ABS plastic mixed with acetone. If there's any builders out there unfamiliar with this process, please leave a comment in the description to the video. I'll happily do a separate tutorial about solvent welding. I also printed out the skirt. It's printed in four pieces. I assembled it and screwed it onto the base using the pre-printed holes. There's also a couple design changes that came up between the first video and now. Most importantly, in my original design, I planned on using these 12mm bolts inserted into each side of the top ring to support the dome, but as I began planning out some of the motors and electronics, I found it would be a lot easier to install a 12mm piece of steel studding across the entire span of the droid. This will give the head a lot more stability and ultimately give me more room to mount things. Another issue that came up during the frame assembly was some difficulty getting some of the pieces to grab onto each other well enough. I added a few of these triangular pieces at some of the joints to give it some extra substrate to solvent weld to. And finally, the top ring has changed quite a bit. Originally, it was going to be a full ring, but as I began playing around with the head rotation and how it was going to nod and bob, I found using this cutout here gave me more room to let the head nod and gave me a few extra degrees of rotation. So that pretty much brings us to where we are now. And you can see I've already made those changes that we just talked about in the digital file. Here's the triangles on the frame, and I made the top ring modification. I plan on releasing these files soon, once I know everything works for sure. And when I do, all of these changes and any changes that come up in the near future will already be incorporated into the files, so there'll be no need to retrofit anything. All right, with all this out of the way, we could focus on the main purpose of this video, which is getting the head mechanism motorized. So let's start with the dome rotation. There's two main thoughts I've had on how to do that. The first is just a wheel inside of a wheel with it driving along the interior rim of the Lazy Susan. And the second idea is pretty similar, only instead of a straight up wheel, it uses a gear and a toothed track. I'm definitely leaning more towards this idea. I'm not sure how well a 3D printed track will hold up over time, but I definitely want to give it an honest go out of the chute. I found this website which generates gears, and you can export your drawings as CAD files and import them right into my 3D program, so it worked out perfectly. I made a 12-tooth wheel to attach to the motor and a 96-tooth track to attach to the Lazy Susan. So 8 motor rotations will make one full dome rotation. That will help when deciding what RPMs to use. I imported the files and extruded them to be a little bit taller than the Lazy Susan. You can see here in this section, this is how it's going to look throughout the entire part. Having a little extra height will help me spread the load off of each tooth a little bit. I plan on printing the 12-tooth wheel out of Semiflex. If you've ever printed with Semiflex before, you know that it's basically solid. It'll just have a little bit of give to it, which will hopefully help mitigate any print warpage or imperfections in the gear itself. Also, the texture is just a little bit softer than hard plastic, so hopefully it'll be a little bit quieter than two pieces of PLA rubbing up against each other. So we'll see how that works. Okay, here's what those parts look like printed out, but before I install them, there's a little bit of a maintenance issue I wanted to address. This Lazy Susan has never really spun super smoothly as I would like it to. It was always a little grindy, and when you combine that with the fact that I probably got some metal shavings in there when I drilled all of those holes, I thought it was probably a good idea to take it apart and clean it out a little bit. While I was researching how to do that, I also found that replacing the stock metal ball bearings with Durlin acetal resin bearings could really go a long way, so I purchased some of those from McMaster Carr, and I emptied out all the stock metal ball bearings. There was 282 of them total. I wiped out the stock grease that came with the rings, and I applied some white lithium grease in its place, which you can grab on Amazon. After that, I closed it up with the new Durlin ball bearings inside, and I have to say the difference in the rotation was night and day. This was a really inexpensive mod. It took me about a half an hour to do, and the results are really fantastic. If you have any issues with your Lazy Susan, I would really consider doing this mod. Okay, I mounted the track onto the Lazy Susan using some 1.5-inch number 10 screws. I also mounted the 12-tooth gear to the motor. It's a Pitman 24-volt motor with a 19.7:1 gear ratio, and it spins at about 200 RPM. The shaft of the Pitman motor is D-shaped, so I recessed a matching cavity into the Semiflex gear to fit. I also left a 3mm channel so I can insert an M3 set screw against the flat portion of that D-shaft. That should keep the wheel nice and secure as it rotates. Now we have to figure out how to mount these pieces to the frame.
My main design is all based off the idea of having a ring mounted to the bottom of the Lazy Susan. As I began playing around with the design, I came up with this interior ring structure that I really like. I added in the Pitman motor to the right side of the droid, and I wanted to keep the motor as close to the axle as I could so the weight would affect the balance as little as possible. From there, I started refining the design and removing sections I didn't need until I came up with these two shapes. They will both mount to the outer ring and have a bearing installed to spin along the axle. They also each have a step in them to allow the gear to rotate freely. So this is what all of that looks like installed. Like I mentioned, there's a bearing in each one of the mounts which the axle will slip through. The mounts are attached to the outer ring of the Lazy Susan using some self-tapping wood screws, and then the whole assembly is threaded through the axle along with two nuts and two lock washers which are used to set the horizontal position along the axle. This is still a very free-spinning assembly, so I attached some zip ties at the front to keep it level while everything was getting installed. I also installed the semi-flex wheel, so now we can test. I have a 12-volt LiPo here, which we can use just to test the rotation. So there's that. I can see right off the bat the semi-flex wheel is pretty wobbly, so that's probably going to need to be replaced or rethought. But for the most part, it looks pretty good. It's way quieter than I thought it was going to be. This is only running 12 volts at the moment. It is a 24-volt motor, so we'll see what happens when we add in the full power. The next step is going to be adding in a control panel so we can start controlling this thing with a microcontroller. I want to use the Shadow Padawan system for this, which uses the PS3 nav controllers. So I'm going to build out that control panel and start putting some code in the Arduino. So here's the control panel. If we go through it starting at the batteries, we have two 12-volt batteries wired in series, giving you 24 volts. Those 24 volts go to a blade fuse that has a 25 amp fuse in it, just for a little protection. From there it goes to power distribution. I have a 24 volt rail here, which gets split into two places. The first place it goes to is to this voltage regulator, which steps the voltage down to 9 volts, and that 9 volts then powers the Arduino. The other place the 24 volts goes to is to this motor controller. This is a BTS7960 motor controller, and that will send a PWM signal to the motor to rotate the dome. All right, we're all set up and ready for our first test. I took the liberty of updating the semi-flex wheel. I bought a motor coupling off Amazon and reprinted the part to fit that. It has four screw holes in the bottom and two recesses for M3 set screws on either side of the D-shaft. This will help ensure that that wheel is really locked onto the motor and is spinning as true as possible. Now we're ready to do our first shadow-based code test. So if we use a PS3 controller, we can move to the left and to the right. So we know the code's doing well. It's using PWM, so we could really slowly move it and speed it up. Stop on a dime, also go the other way. And we really have some good speed control here based off of the stick and how much I'm moving it left to right. We're also now at 24 volts. Before we were running this at 12 volts, so this is the full speed of the dome. Okay, great. I think that works awesome. The next step is going to be getting rid of these zip ties by installing the nod functionality. That will keep this entire assembly level and give us the ability to move it up and down and give Chopper his nod. So let's take a look in 3D Studio Max at how we're going to do that.
Okay, so this little servo installation is what's going to control our nod. The servo is a high-tech HS805BB+ servo. It's super beefy and it should be all we need, especially with how little travel this function actually needs. It's mounted to the frame using the pre-printed mounting holes, and it sits on a little printed plate. The other end of the mechanism is another one of my ring structures attached to the outside of the Lazy Susan. Connecting the two pieces, I have a simple lever-type deal. In these little circular recesses will be two bearings so that the ends can rotate freely. Then as the servo rotates, it pushes the head up and down. At this point, I'm going to add in that revised top ring to the frame so we can start testing the extents of the nod. To do that, we'll also need the bottom portion of the dome, so I'm going to start printing a test head. At least the bottom part for now so we can see this thing in action. I do plan on building a full test head for the next video so I can figure out all the electronics mounts and start working on the head arms. So this will just be the first piece of that test head. If we look at the rotation from the side in a section view, we can see that we get about 3 degrees of rotation in each direction before it hits. That doesn't sound like a lot because it isn't, but I think that subtle nod will really go a long way on the final droid. Okay, all that set up, we can test out the servo control. And we still have the rotation. Okay, I think that's working pretty good. Okay, I added in the bottom ring of that test head to see how it looks with the nod. You can see even though it's only 3 degrees of rotation, it's quite a bit of tilt, and as the head gets taller, that tilt will be accentuated more and more. You can see in the rotation that the test head's a little bit wonky. I probably could have printed it a little bit better, but for the purposes of this test, I think it's perfect. I took the liberty of printing the rest of the test head. Now, since I'm going to need it for the next video anyway, I figured I would add it in so we can see what the entire head structure looks like with the nod and the rotation. There's definitely a lot more wobble in this mechanism than I would like. That's definitely coming from the plate that the servo is mounted to. It's only attached to one crossbar with two screws, so I think if I flush that out a little bit, I can reduce that wobble quite a bit and it'll look a little bit more stable. Okay, so we have a functional nod and a functional dome rotation. I think that's where we're going to leave it for this video. Next time I'm going to stick with the head and try to tackle the head arms, so that should be a lot of fun. If you like these videos, please subscribe and also check out the links in the description to my social media accounts, and I'll see you next time.